Good evening, wherever you are, brethren in the Lord. I come to you with the peace of the Lord, the joy and the grace. This morning, this evening, wherever you are, I say to you, good evening, and may the peace of the Lord be with you. At this moment, I want you to like and share this wonderful life to family and friends, and our life shall never be the same. Yes, Lord. This is a wonderful song being composed by Bill Witter. It's a Lean on Me. It's a wonderful song to encourage souls. No matter what the song or who composed it. Yeah. But this evening, wherever you are, I want you to know that God is on your side and he has you. Okay? Alright. Yes, Lord. I want you to share the life and bless someone with this wonderful life message that is coming. Yes, Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, share the life and bless someone with it. Bless someone with a message. Yes. Father, we thank you, we bless your name. Share the life and bless someone. Share the life and bless someone. This is a song composed by Bill so many years ago, Lean on Me. And people may say it's not a gospel song or whatever, but this song carries some motivation and encourage and hope. Yes. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Ladies and gentlemen, let's pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, for bringing us here this evening. You have come here to share your word, to give your children hope through the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. As your word go forth, Father, we pray that may you save souls through this word in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Please, this evening, I'm here to share the word of God with you and to tell you about the spirit of suicide. Ladies and gentlemen, the spirit of suicide is not a spirit of who lies to people live, but it's a spirit to destroy souls, to destroy believers, Christians, and loved ones. The emotion scars left to family and friends in the wake of suicide are deep and produce not only feelings of loneliness, but often a sense of guilt and disorientation. these negative feelings may be compounded by the plague question of what Bible says about suicide. And suicide is a tragic reality in our fallen world, that people experience desperation to the point that they believe the best option is to end their own lives. It's heartbreaking. And to lose one loved one to suicide prompt a rate of questions and a special kind of grief. But the Bible offers hope both to those who are considering suicide and to those who have been affected by the suicide of another. God doesn't want you to die by suicide. More specifically, Jesus does not want you to kill yourself. If you're having suicidal thought, please look for a counselor or a professional immediately. Or you can contact me on my Facebook Messenger immediately. If you think you cannot deal with it, committing or killing yourself is not the solution to whatever depressed, anxiety, frustration you have. Are we together? And when we talk of suicide is the act of, self-killing, slaughter. And the Bible says that thou shalt not murder. So it is something that God hates, but the devil is interested in it. And it is an intentional action taken to end your life as a result of self-rejection. Are we together? And dejections and humiliation, low self-esteem and what? So the spirit of suicide is responsible of suicidal thoughts. It's often hard to pray when you are consumed with suicidal thought. And as I said earlier on, it is from the devil. Are we together? It is from the devil. So we shouldn't take it lightly. Praise the Lord. We shouldn't take it lightly, because there are people that they need to be talked to. Eh? And there are people also that are there, are ready, that you can talk to. Praise the Lord. And suicidal thought only survive within an outlook of complete hopelessness. Many people who struggle with suicidal thought feel like they are alone. But suicidal thought is the extreme dead end of hopelessness. Allowing thought of hopelessness to control your thinking narrows and darkens your path till suicide appears to be the only option. But it is not. Hello? But it is not. Suicidal thought is not the solution. Ladies and gentlemen, there are plenty of other solutions. You just can't see them now because hopelessness has blinded you to them. Praise the Lord. So you would be surprised by how much the Bible talks about suicide. There are several helpful examples of those who took their life, and many reminds of hope through the scriptures. True Bible hope is the best antidote for hopelessness. Take the hope that is resident in the promises of God and put it into your heart. Your outlook will change it. Hallelujah. So God has a wonderful habit of raising individual out of impossibility situation. He enjoys doing it, and it brings him glory.
to those who are desperate, please, please recognize that suicide is not the best option. In Christ, there is hope. Also, recognize that you are not alone. Killing yourself is not the situation, is not the solution to your situation. In fact, the Bible speaks of many who felt deep despair in life. Solomon, in his pursuit of pleasure, reached the point where he hated life. Ecclesiastes chapter 2, verse 17. Do you understand? Even Elijah was fearful and depressed and yearned for death. Jonah was so angry at God that he wished to die. Even the Apostle Paul and his missionary companions at one point. So he says that in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 8. We're under great pressure for beyond our ability to endure, so that we despair of life itself. And brother and my sister, the Bible is full of stories of people just like you. They were delivered out of extremely dangerous and potentially embarrassing situations, including God's own son Jesus. So you are no different. Reject the guilt and shame and absorb his love, forgiveness and hope. You will make it out of this situation. The darkness will not last. And this is the real truth. That is the real truth. But for it to work, you must see it as truth and believe it. And this is where reading your Bible, speaking to people, talking to people, meditating on God's promises come in, and they will grow hope and belief in your heart. So allow God's good word to cheer you up. God's word is the only true source of hope, because it shows us, or it shows the will of Him who can help. Allow the hope of a good result to seep back into your heart. Are we together? So the hope that is resident in the promises of God's will open the eyes of your heart, and you'll be able to see again. It will get brighter. Suicide only appear like an option when the devil has hidden all your other options. Allow the Bible to open your eyes. Allow the Word of God to open your eyes. Allow the Holy Spirit to talk to you. Allow God to talk to you. Avail yourself. Accept it, that this is what you are going through, but let's find solution. Hanging yourself, shooting yourself with a gun, poisoning yourself, they are not the solution. Listen, there are supernatural strength and healing when you claim the power of God and gain support to fight on. More importantly, pray. It's often the very last thing you want to do. You will therefore require self-discipline, self-control, and strength that can only come from God. So killing yourself is an act of trying to force your will on God. If you have read the Bible, you will know that forcing our will on God never works. Forcing our will on God never works. You see, while there is a lot of suffering in the Bible, God promises to be with us through it all. God called us to continue and perceive through the hardship of life. So why would you kill yourself? Because you can't pay your rent, your bills? Because insurance company are chasing you? Because of a loan you went in and the loan company is chasing you? Because of marriage? Because of you couldn't have a better life? Because of your past? Oh. Because of someone has done something to you? No. Don't kill yourself. And don't kill other person. Do you know how God needs you? Do you know how the family, your loved ones needs you? Do you know how your country needs you? Do you know how your children needs you? When you kill yourself today, how would you know what you will become tomorrow? Killing yourself, is destroying your generation. Committing suicide is destroying the future, the generation of your family to come. It looks like when you kill yourself, it looks like you have killed a chicken with eggs. A chicken that has eggs and is it is laying on the egg, and you kill the chicken, and the eggs of the chicken. How many chicken are you going to have? You see, God called us to continue to perceive this hardship of life. So the Bible says that. In 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9 to 10 says that, "But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. My power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast all the more gladly about my weakness." In the time of weakness, we need to boast. We need to be proud. We need to be happy. There must be a joy. You see, and the Bible went and says that so that Christ's power may rest on me. In our time of weakness, the power of Christ, the resurrection power, the power of the Holy Spirit rests upon us. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, in insult, in hardship, in persecutions, in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Committing suicide? No. As a believer, the worldly people also do it, but this is a message to everyone. If you're a believer or you are not a believer, killing yourself. Look, this is what is happening this 2024. A lot of souls have been taken, lives have been lost. It is not anything, they commit suicide. Some people intentionally, when they are driving, they use their car to knock down a tree. Someone who poisoned himself or herself, someone who hung, like how Judas Iscariot did. You see, no matter sin, no matter mistake you have made, you are not the only person. No one on this earth has made the mistakes. If you have never fucked up before, just let me know. Everyone has fucked up in life before, but we still goes on. Whatever that happened, it makes us grow. My brother, are we together? So we must not commit suicide. We must not kill ourselves. Hello? Because God also has determined the length of our lives in advance. So be honest, you cannot discern the future or know what amazing things God plans to do through you. God has a future for you and plans for you. that is so detailed as to include the number of days you are to be on earth. Your eyes saw, St. David says that in Psalm 139, 16, he said, your eyes saw my unfold body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. So suicide breaks one of the 10 commandments. God has clearly instructed us not to murder, not to kill ourselves, not to kill anyone. When you die by suicide, it is as ugly as it sounds. It violates one of God's commands. Suicide is a form of self-murder. So the Bible says that you shall not murder. We know the causes of suicide. Emotional trauma, just name them. Death of a loved one, heartbreak, failure, depression, financial, hopelessness, rejection and dejection, bipolar disorder and alcoholism and substance abuse, mental illness and disorder. There are a lot, but we shouldn't allow all these kind of causes come to stay with us. So as you are there and you feel hopeless and dejection and rejection, there are signs of suicide spirit. Being alone feels you have no reason to go on living, and making a will or giving away personal possessions, searching for means of doing personal harm, such as getting insecticide or drugs or gun, sleeping too much or too little, eating too little or eating too much, resulting in significant weight gain and loss. When you engage in reckless behaviors, including excessive alcohol, drug consumption, is a sign. Depressed or seeing suicide as a way out. So we have to put a stop to it. Killing yourself, no, my brother, my sister, no. You've given the way, you've given the enemy the joy and the happiness. Because when you kill yourself, when he manipulates you, influence you, you kill yourself. What do you gain? You let the enemy be happy. And we lost souls to the kingdom of God. So what to do is to get rid of suicidal thoughts. Stay positive. Focus your mind on the things God has blessed you with and not on the things you lack. Furthermore, be content. Hallelujah. Rebuke that evil voices, whatever it comes, ministering suicidal thought, rebuke it. Say, I rebuke any suicidal voices of the enemy. I rebuke it, I rebuke it, I rebuke it. And always feed your soul with the word of God. And also listen to Christian songs. It will help you lift up your spirit whenever you are down. Surrender yourself with positive minds and never forsake Christian gathering or groups or meeting. For the sake of clarity, we should state that suicide is a sin against God and every person or others. So, however, suicide does not determine a person's eternal destiny. Our eternal destiny rests solely on God's grace. So those who trust in Jesus Christ are fully forgiven of every sin and they receive what? Eternal life. Those who reject Him remain condemned. Hallelujah. This evening, wherever you are, our eternal rock of ages, we appreciate for whatever He has done for us, for you and I, from the time of our birth till our parent day. Glory to be His name. We ask you, O God, that you purge us of all uncleanness and unrighteousness, that will be made whole in the name of Jesus. We plead that your message speaks for us today as we make this prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. According to your word, O Lord, we receive the gift of abundant life, and the enemy can never take it away from us in the name of Jesus. By the power in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we silence every voices whispering to us and planting suicide thought in us in the name of Jesus Christ, because Jesus lived a life also, because Jesus prevailed, and I shall prevail, because Jesus do not fail, I shall not also fail. Therefore, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we cast down any suicidal thought, any suicidal feelings of killing ourselves, any feelings of loneliness, any spirit of rejection, any spirit of dejection in the name of Jesus Christ. And we declare total freedom to our spirit, body, soul in the name of Jesus Christ. May you receive the peace of God upon your mind. May you receive the peace of God upon your spirit. May you receive the peace of God upon your destiny. May you receive the peace of God upon your earth. May you receive the peace of God in your marriage. May you receive the peace of God in your ministry. May you receive the peace of God in your business. And in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we ask the precious Holy Spirit to fill up our head, our heart, our mind with the right thought. May the Holy Spirit erase from any form of negative or negativity of thought in our life in the name of Jesus Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, in God's infinite love and mercy, He sent His beloved Son to die for our sins, that we live and not perish. So this evening we declare, I decree and declare on your behalf in the name of Jesus Christ, you shall not die, you shall not perish, but you will have eternal life in the name of Jesus. No weapon of the enemy of suicidal thought, any rejection of the enemy, any detection, any depression, any frustration will come near you in the name of Jesus Christ. We declare that in every life storm, we shall only focus on Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith in the name of Jesus Christ. We give glory to His name and we thank Him for the grace, the privilege given to us in the name of Jesus Christ. We say that as the Bible says that, and upon my desire there shall be deliverance. We seek a total deliverance from our mindset, from our heart, and from our body, our soul, that the enemy has planted a strong thought in us to commit suicide, to kill ourselves. We bind the spirit of suicide. We bind the spirit of rejection in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, we come to you this moment. Any thought of the enemy that is pulling us down to commit suicide, any spirit, any push of the power of the end that is operating in the life of your children for them to commit suicide, we bind this spirit of suicidal thought in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says that if the Son of God set you free, yes, indeed, you are free. Say, I am free in the name of Jesus. Say, I am free in the name of Jesus. We ask the Holy Spirit to dwell in our boat, to dwell in us, because the Bible says where the Spirit is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit is, there is freedom. Where the Spirit of God is, there is liberation. There is freedom. There is freedom. We ask for freedom. We ask for freedom. We ask for freedom from any spirit of suicide. Romans chapter 8 verse 31 says that, what then shall we say to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? We thank God for everything that He has done for us. In the name of Jesus Christ, by the authority He has given to us, we bind anything and it shall be bound in heaven. We bind every spirit of suicide against our life, against our family, and we cast them to the abyss where they shall remain bound unto the judgment day in the name of Jesus Christ. By the same authority to lose anything, it shall be loosed. I lose myself, we lose ourselves, our children, we lose them, our spouse, we lose them from the grip of spirit of suicide now. We lose us, we lose ourselves, and we lose it, and we say, let us go in the name of Jesus Christ. Ladies and gentlemen, let the Lord's heart, great and strong sword of fire, locate the spirit of suicide hovering around us and attempting to deprive us of attaining the successful future God has for us. We command the consuming fire of God to consume every atom of darkness that seeps hopelessness in our life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree and declare that all things shall work together for our good. In the name of Jesus Christ, every sin or omission of the past that keeps rearing in our head and making it difficult to forgive ourselves, even after the Lord has forgiven me, we silence that thing now. Blood of Jesus, flush out every suicidal thought, the evil voices of suicide that it keep dropping in our mind. Blood of Jesus, God, to flush them out in the name of Jesus. Loving Spirit of God, you saturate with the love and peace of God that surpasses human understanding, that we may find pleasure in living and be able to emit love to people around, and in return receive love. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, let the joy of the Lord fill you to the brim and leave no vacuum for the enemy to penetrate. From this day forth, you receive the fruit of the Spirit in full dose in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, can you lift up your hand or just be there and say this after me? Say, Heavenly Father, I thank you for sending your Son to come and die for me. I admit it that I'm a sinner, but today I have taken you and accepted you in my heart that you are my Savior. You have become my own and my Savior, and I've taken you as my personal Savior as well. Lord Jesus, remain forever in my life. I know that I'm a sinner, but today, as you come into my heart, I am not a sinner. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for coming into my life. Amen. Amen. God bless you, and congratulations to you that you are a new believer. Look for Bible Believing Church and attend, and to go according to the word of God and the commandment of God. Suicide is not the best option. That shouldn't come into your mind at all. Don't allow the devil to take in charge of your body, for your body is the temple of God. Know that Jesus Christ needs you. Your family needs you. I need you. Your country needs you. Your brothers and sisters need you. And one day, you bear a testimony to the glory of God. Amen. If you want to talk to me, or you want to contact me for counseling concerning any voices, what is going on in your mind, having suicidal thought, you feel like you are being rejected, you are alone, don't hesitate to contact me on my Facebook Messenger or my WhatsApp number. I'll respond to you quickly, just in 24 hours, even if it is less. And also, those that are watching, those who, if you want to bless me, if you want to sow a seed, also, if you want to give any donation, I can give you my Cash App by contacting me on my Facebook Messenger, and I'll respond to you. God bless you all. May the peace and the love of God be with you. May the Holy Spirit fill you, and may the angels of the Lord surround you. May the consuming fire of the Lord be a wall around you and your family. And tomorrow, by this time, we will meet again. God bless you all. See you tomorrow in the morning. Peace. Shalom.